Assalamu alaikum. We are continuing with tutorial 2, right? We solved all the questions of the midterm for you. And now, this part of the tutorial, we will be solving quiz 3. So let us start with the first question of the quiz. Some portions were multiple choice and some others were true false. So these are some of the multiple choice. Of course, as I keep on reminding you, in this tutorial I can cover only a few of the multiple choice and true false. There could be much more from the chapters and so on. The first one, in dash friction, frictional stress is directly proportional to normal stress. Sliding, sticking, stick slip, none of these. So if you remember from the lectures, video lectures and so on, the type of friction where frictional stress is proportional to the normal stress is the sliding part. When sticking happens, then it is stuck, it is not moving anyhow. And a stick slip is another type of friction situation, is a stick sometimes slips sometimes. So the only correct answer is sliding friction. Dash is a type of forging operation. Open die forging, impression die forging, flashless forging. So you know all of them are correct. So all of these is the answer, right? Is a type of forging operation. All of these are types of forging operations. A strength parameter used in calculation of rolling force is average flow stress, yield strength, ultimate strength, any of these. Now, we know that in all rolling, forging, extrusion and so on, we use the flow stress. So even if you are unsure, yield strength wrong, ultimate strength wrong, any of these wrong, so this would be the only correct answer. But the other thing is that you have the formula sheet with you. You are not supposed to look into the book or the lecture notes and so on because of your honor statement. But the formula sheet is available. So rolling force calculation, the average flow stress is there in the formula. So this is the answer. Structural shapes such as I-beams and C-channels are generally produced by which operation? Rolling, extrusion, forging, drawing. So of course you know, you have done rolling to a lot of extent, that these I-beams, W-channels, C-channels, angles, these are special shapes which are very important for the construction industry, for buildings and bridges and airports and so on. And rolling is the main operation by which we produce these special shapes. Let us move to the second part of question 1, which is true-false. So we will just include a few true-false type. Barreling occurs in open die forging due to good lubrication. So barreling, yes, occurs in open die forging, but barreling occurs when the friction is very high. So that means the lubrication is bad, right? So barreling does not occur for good lubrication. So what should it be? False, right? It is false. A strain rate in forging can be defined in terms of velocity and height. Velocity and height. There was one slide where we were reminding you of the basic formulas of a stress and a strain and a strain rate and so on. So in forging, of course, height is being changed. Height is being changed. Delta H is the change in height. And if velocity and height are used, then yes, a strain rate can be defined. Right, so this is true. If rolls start to slip, normally in rolling there is enough friction between the roll and the billet material so that the billet material keeps on moving forward and the rolling operation keeps on going. But if it starts to slip, the neutral point has moved all the way to the beginning of the entry zone. You see, this is the roll. here it starts to touch and there it starts to leave, right? Rolling is happening, the material is touching the roll, so this is the entry, and here the roll, the material is leaving the roll, so this is the exit. If rolling, it starts to slip, then the neutral point which was in the middle has moved all the way to the end. So what should be the answer here? False. It does not go to the entry zone. The neutral point moves to the exit zone if slipping is happening. Difference between the initial and final heights in rolling is known as draft. Difference in initial and final heights, delta H, yes, it is known as draft, right? The technical name for delta H in rolling is draft. Yes, so this is true. Okay, so this was the multiple choice and true false. Let us now move to the numerical question. Let us read it. A 42 millimeter thick plate, initial thickness, made of low carbon steel, material is given, is to be reduced to 34 millimeter in one pass, final thickness, in a rolling operation. The operation is rolling. As the thickness is reduced, the plate widens by 4%, right? The thickness reduces from 42 to 34. So if the thickness is reduced, the width is increased. So the increase in width is 4%. Yield strength of the steel plate is 174 megapascal. Ultimate tensile strength is 290 megapascal. Interest speed of the plate is 15 meters per minute. Roll radius is 325 millimeter. Rotational speed is 49 revolutions per minute, right? Capital N. Determine a minimum required coefficient of friction that would make this rolling operation possible. B, exit velocity of the plate. C, forward slip. So once again, if you are doing this as a practice session, which you should, then stop the lecture, pause the lecture, take your pencil, paper, calculator, start solving it. Once you have finished solving it and you are very sure of your result, then come back and compare with the answers. If you think that in the quiz you got 10 out of 10 on this, your marks are very high, you don't need to revise it, then you can continue with the lecture. So if you are listening to me now, it means you have already finished solving it in detail. So what is the first step always? Read the question carefully and take down the data, knowns and the unknowns. So write T0, initial thickness, TF, final thickness, low carbon steel, material, change in width, delta T by 4%, yield strength, sigma Y of the material 174, ultimate tensile strength, sigma UTS of the material 290, entrance speed, velocity V, 15 meters per minute, roll radius, capital R, 325, rotational speed, capital N, 49 revolutions per minute, RPM. Minimum required coefficient of friction, mu, is unknown. Exit velocity, VF, if that was V0, then this is VF, exit velocity, unknown. Forward slip, you will see in the formula sheet, S is equal to unknown. So you have three unknowns and you have these values. So there is not much to do. You have the formula sheet where rolling operation is given. So in that formula sheet, you will see that maximum draft delta H, we can call it D max, but delta H in our formula sheet is mu squared R. The draft means the change in thickness. The draft is change in thickness. So 42 minus 34 is the draft, right? The draft, delta H, T naught minus TF is 42 minus 34. So draft is known. Capital R is 325. So then mu squared is equal to D upon R. Mu is equal to under root of that. So it comes out to be 0.157. There are no units. Mu is just a coefficient, it is just a number, right? It is just a number, because here It is meters here, it is meters, or millimeter, millimeter, they cancel out, it is just an. So this is the coefficient of friction for this problem, right? So very simple, just look into the formula sheet. It is given that draft is equal to mu squared r, and just plug and play, right? So this is the solution of the first part, right? Minimum required coefficient of friction. Next part, exit velocity of the plate. Now it is given that the plate increases in width by 4%. Initial volume is equal to final volume, right? Initial thickness, initial width, right, into initial velocity. So this is the initial volume flow rate. Final thickness, final width, final velocity, right, and so on. Now this final width is 40% more. So whatever is W naught, it is 1.04. Sorry, 4%. I'm very sorry. 4%. Right? 0.4. So WF is 1.04 W naught. Right? Do you understand this? Very clear. That the final width is 4% more. So if the initial width is W naught, the final width is 1.04 W naught. So now T naught is 42. Substitute this. W naught is W naught. V naught is given as 15 meters per minute, so this is 15. T final is given as 34, right? W final is 1.04 W naught, and VF is final velocity. So this is your equation. W naught cancels out. Just find VF from here, and because all other values are in the same units, but the velocity was given in meters per minute, so it will be directly given in meters per minute. So it is 17.8 meters per minute. Of course, if you divide it by 60, then it will be in meters per second. So you can do that if you like. But because you see this W naught and this W naught cancels away, this T naught is in the same unit on both the sides. So the velocity unit is the same as the initial velocity unit. So this is the second part. This is the second part. The third part, forward slip. So if you see in the formula sheet, forward slip S is VF minus VR upon VR. It is also given in the lecture notes and so on. This is final velocity, but this is VR. You see, now let me explain something to you. The velocity, if you have capital N as the velocity of rolling, right? So if you want to convert capital N into a velocity, it is 2 pi Rn upon 60, right? It is 2 pi Rn or pi d, 2 pi is d or pi dn, right? So 2 pi Rn upon 60 in meters per second, or pi dn in meters per minute. This is a very old thing from your physics and earlier things. Something is rotating, so 2 pi r is the circumference, or pi d, 2 pi r or the circumference. So this circumference is the distance, and per minute it is rotating revolutions per minute. So 2 pi rn or pi dn. So but that is the exit velocity. But the surface speed of rolls VR is not VF. That was VF. If we had to calculate VF, then we could use this. But surface speed of rolls, this VR, is pi R squared N, not pi Rn, pi R squared N. So this is the only difference, that if you look into the book and so on, or some other notes, then you will see that in rolling, VR is pi r squared n. So therefore, for this VR, you find pi r squared n, whose value is 16.26 meters per minute. You substitute this value and you get this result, right? So this completes the tutorial part, which was about the third quiz 3.